across the line. It's all still to play for.
How much have they taken out of their tyres? Actually catching up Danny Pedrosa and getting past him. Two laps for Jorge Lorenzo to rule here in a red. Up at turn one.
0.3 now the gap between them, but that doesn't matter. He's right on Danny Pedrosa's tail now, and he surely will have a chance to go through. Pedrosa must be struggling with those tyres, struggling with the problems with the front end he's had on his Honda all year. And Jorge Lorenzo, early on in the race, is really biding his time, and here comes Lorenzo. Maybe a shot move in Sito Pons corner, or will it be down the end of the straight? Has he got the grunts on the Yamaha to match the Honda?
This is where he's going to try it. He's going to get out of here quick. The Sito Pons corner not close enough at the moment. Wants to get a little bit closer before
here
they
he
break
comes.
For
Tritac.
He's
he
on
comes.
The brakes. Up the inside comes Jorge Lorenzo. Will he make it stick? Will Pedrosa run it wide? Pedrosa just hangs in there.
Oh,
no!
He almost touched on the exit from the corner. Lorenzo took the tight line, held his bike in there. Such bravery from the Mallorcan. But Pedrosa holds him off. There's going to be another chance, surely.
Could all end in tears. Who said Danny Pedrosa can't scrap it out at the front? And a rear end wiggle there from the Honda from Danny Pedrosa. Lorenzo's got to do it all over again.
This is going to be an amazing last lap with the fans all on their feet. Valentino Rossi 1.3 seconds behind is a spectator, but could pick up the pieces if there was any collision between these two. There almost was at turn six on that last lap at the end of the back straight. Now down into Ducato's. Is there a chance for a move? This was it. Lorenzo very, very tight. Just kept his bike in there. Wants to get the exit. Oh, and Lorenzo's tried it. That's Ducato's corner. And Pedrosa hangs him out to dry in the corner. Back to turn one this time. Is there another chance for Lorenzo? Brilliant stuff this is.
Into turn one, one lap to go here at Jerez, a classic Spanish Grand Prix between two great Spanish riders, both of them former world champions. They're at turn two, full marks to Pedrosa. He's fallen off. Two big efforts from Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo surely will have another go, either at Sito Pons as we ride with him, but surely down at Drysack.
Even if he has a go at Drysack, surely in the final corner there's going to be something going on. Is it going to be echoes of Doohan and Cribier? Is it going to be echoes of Rossi and Gibbonau in that final corner? Pedrosa and Lorenzo, the new breed, having a brilliant scrap here. On board with Lorenzo.
Here he comes, Jorge Lorenzo. He got up the inside on the brakes. Brakes, who's going to leave it later? No, Danny Pedrosa holds him up, runs him wide. Lorenzo takes the lead.
Pedrosa wide. Can Rossi get through? Because that's very wide from Danny Pedrosa. That's going to be the move that seals it from Jorge Lorenzo. He didn't even push Pedrosa. He just let him know he was there. Pedrosa knew he had to take the wider line and try and squirt it out the corner. But it wasn't going to happen. Listen to the fans as they come into the stadium section for the final time.
Less than half a lap to go. They are going absolutely crazy here in Jerez. 122,000 Spanish fans are on their feet. What a ride by Lorenzo. He will take over the lead in the World Championship after two rounds if he just stays aboard the Yamaha. Two bends to go for the Mallorcan.
And he's going to push it very, very hard into this final corner. He'll think Pedrosa's there. Very tight line from Jorge Lorenzo, but he's done it. He's going to win the Spanish Grand Prix and make up for his disappointments over the last couple of years. Brilliant, brilliant riding from Lorenzo. Three riders across the line within a second. That's your podium, Lorenzo, Pedrosa, Rossi.
Classic at the front, coming under enormous pressure.
He's not looked like cracking once, has he?
No, he hasn't.
Absolutely rock solid. He's like granite at the front, isn't he, when he's there at Jorge Lorenzo. Now Marquez has got to do all the hard work again for the third time. Will he be third time lucky when he gets by Jorge Lorenzo? If he gets by Jorge Lorenzo.
Time is beginning to run out for Marc Marquez. There's 1.5 laps to go of this Italian Grand Prix. Up over the rise they come towards Correntino.
And Andrea Iannone fought his way back into third place by Dani Pedrosa. So we've got a great battle for the win between Lorenzo and Marquez. There's an equally exciting scrap for third place between Iannone and Pedrosa. It's advantage Ducati right now.
He's going to get one more chance, you feel, don't you, Marc Marquez? It's hard. He doesn't want to take too many risks. The championship is absolutely poised as we come up to the one-third distance. Up over the rise they come. Will he have another go at San Donato? One lap to go here in Mugello. Side by side they come.
5 kilometres to go. Marquez has got the inside line. He gets it all out of shape on the brakes. Lorenzo again superb in the braking zone for the first corner. No way through this time for Marquez.
Lorenzo has repelled all borders so far. But Marquez is going to have one more go. It's not going to be at San Donato anymore. Where is it going to be? Closes up as they run across the top end of the circuit. Here he comes!
Marquez is through this time around, and he's made it stick. Now, what has Jorge Lorenzo got as a counter-attack? Marquez leads for the first time in this race. They drop down through Casanova. They'll bank it left, then through Savelli. Has Marquez timed this to absolute perfection? What have you got, Lorenzo?
Well, it's a different game now for Jorge Lorenzo. He's done all the defending. Now he's got to do the attacking. They bottom out Arrapiata 1, up to Arrapiata 2. Half a lap to go here in Mugello. What a ride by Marquez.
Marc Marquez has got all bases covered so far. No way through for Jorge Lorenzo at Scarperia. And then through Pelagio. Marc Marquez will then drop down the hill to Correntino, heading for his third win of the season. Lorenzo, though, won't let him have it without a fight. Not close enough to attack at turn number 12. Lorenzo's got to try and line him up for a move out of Biondetti. Can he get close enough to attack on the brakes at the final corner? Here we go.
Here he comes up the inside of Biondetti. What a move by Jorge Lorenzo. Marquez fights back. They're side by side coming up to the final corner, and it's Lorenzo who's going to go through. No, he's not. Marquez has fought him off. Now it is the run to the line.
Surely Marc Marquez has got this victory in the bag. Marquez, he's been magic in Mugello. What a mesmerising race. Lorenzo tries to find him. Lorenzo's got it on the line. Unbelievable. What a finish here in Mugello. Marc Marquez lost it on the line, but to Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo wins by 0.1 seconds. What a race. Yeah.